homage to our founding teacher Shakyamuni Buddha, homage to our founding teacher Shakyamuni Buddha, homage to our founding teacher Shakyamuni Buddha, homage to Shila Assembly of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, homage to the Shila Assembly of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, homage to Shila Assembly of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. So we start to talk about this precept sutra, a precept sutra. We will talk about Wu Jie Shang Jing. So we'll recite this verse, opening the sutra, Chinese verse. Wu Shang Shen Shen Wei Miao Hua, Bai Qian Wan Jie Lan Cao Yu, Wu Jin Jian Wei Lang De Shou Chi, Yuan Jie Lu Lai Chen Shi Yi. Supreme the wondrous Dharma, subtle and profound, rarely is encountered, even in billions of years. When I see and hear it, accept and uphold it, may I truly understand the Buddha's actual meaning. We are still talking about the precept against killing. Remember the factors for the heavy offense. 还记得这个要犯众的条件吗？ 有五个条件，对不对？ What's the factor, the first factor? 第一个条件是什么？ 是人。 And human. And the second factor, 第二个条件。 You perceive a human. And 第三个条件, the third one. You have intention to kill. Then this is, of course, you take actions. Can be either body or speech. 这个是动, 身或是动口. 那最后一个条件, the last one, the victim must die. Okay. So when you satisfy all these five conditions, then you commit a heavy offense. 如果你能满足这五条件的话, 那你就犯了重罪. In other words, you want to kill a human, and you perceive this being as a human, and of course you have intention to kill, and this person was killed by you, then you commit heavy offense. 就是说你想要杀某一个人, 他是个人嘛, 对不对? 那你也是想到对方确实是他, 然后你有那个杀心, 那最后这个人命断掉, 命断了, 那这条件都满足了, 那你就犯重。 那如果没有满足的话, 就看情形, so if the factors are not satisfied, then it's not going to be a heavy offense. If the victim doesn't die, then it's an intermediate offense. Even though all other four factors are satisfied, then the last one is not satisfied, then it's an intermediate offense. 那如果前四个条件都满足，你就杀人，但是这个人没有被你杀死，那这个就是中品罪，可以忏。那如果是杀的是畜生，你的目的是要杀畜生、杀动物，那这个就是下品罪，是个轻罪。 Your intention is to kill an animal, that's including insects. 那这个是下品罪，轻罪。这个畜生呢，也包括小昆虫在内，蚂蚁啊、蚊子，这个都包括在内。And then we also say that if you kill a non-human, then it's an intermediate offense. non-human are other beings other than animals and human, such as devas, ghosts. 那你如果杀的对象是非人的话，是个中品罪。这个非人的定义就是，除了人和动物以外，就是非人。OK。那我们上礼拜谈的很多呢，所谓的无眼火坑，记不记得无眼火坑那个例子？那我们做个复习。So last week we spent all the time talking about the case. You set up a small dense fire pit and different scenarios. And this is a summary table. Let's review that. So I think it's a very important table to know that, to familiar with, understand that. 那这个是一个摘要的一个表，那这表很重要，我们要希望大家都能够很清楚的了解它。第一个，你如果想要，你目的是要杀人，你目的是要杀人，那你这个人，你确实杀了人，那这就是重罪。如果你杀的这个人没有死掉，你杀的是非人呢，或者杀畜生的话，那是重罪。And so your intention is to kill a human, and the human die, then this is a heavy offense. It satisfies all the five conditions, factors. And if it's a non-human die, then it's an intermediate offense. And animal die is also an intermediate offense. 那这个我想人是重罪，非人是重罪，不难理解。但是就畜生动物是重罪，这个一般人就比较难了解它，难觉得很奇怪。So I think it's easy to understand that when you kill a human, you commit a heavy offense, and non-human is an intermediate offense. However,When you kill an animal, in this case, it's an intermediate offense. That is a bit difficult to understand, to accept that. 那这个，我想我们把这个问题先留在那边，我们继续看下去。I'm not going to explain why it's an intermediate offense. You kill an animal for now. Let's keep going and later on we'll come back to explain why this is intermediate offense. Now suppose you are going to kill a non-human, and if a non-human die, it's an intermediate offense, right? Say non-human offense. 那你如果是要杀非人，那非人，这个非人死的话，这是重品罪，因为他不像人那样，人是重罪。杀非人是重病罪，但是呢，你畜生死掉，你杀的是误杀畜生的话，这个畜生是轻罪，这个也容易了解。So if an animal die, it's a light offense. This is easy to understand. But when a human die, in this case, it's not a heavy offense. It's not intermediate offense. It's a light offense as well. This is.Not easy to understand either, right? Just like in this case, this animal dies in the middle. 那如果是人死的话，这个他不是重罪，也不是中罪，重点是而是轻罪，这个也是不容易了解的事情。这个问题和这个畜生是中品罪是一样的问题，一样的原则。Okay?And let's continue. 那如果你目的是要杀动物畜生的话，畜生被你杀死了，那是轻罪，因为畜生是比较低级的动物，所以这个也没有问题。So now if your intention is to kill an animal, and the animal die, and that's a life offense, okay? Because the animals are lower being than than human, than non-human, can say that solicitor offense makes sense. However, if it's a non-human die, it's also a life offense. Even the human die is still a life offense. So this will be difficult to understand. 那如果是非人死的话，还是轻罪。那人死的话也是轻罪，所以这个也是比较难去理解的事情。So now let's come back to discuss why this is an intermediate offense anymore. This life offense is easy to understand, and also why this human life offense here.那我们现在回过头来看看，为什么这个畜生死掉在这边是重品罪而不是轻罪，那人死呢，这里是轻罪而不是重罪。 OK, the reason why this is intermediate offense was because your intention is to kill a human. When you succeed in killing human, of course it's heavy offense, and if youAre unsuccessful, then it's supposed to be one level lighter than heavy offense. It doesn't matter whether what are being killed, whether it's non-human or whether it's animal, because the important thing is your intention is to kill human.So, 那这个要紧的就是说你这边你目的是要杀人，那人死的话那么是重罪，那人没有死你杀到其他 的众生的话，那就等于是杀人未遂，所以杀人未遂的话应该是比已遂罪来的轻一级、不管哪个什么众生被杀掉都是重品罪，因为是重罪下面一级就是重品罪，所以这个我们看的是看你要杀的对象是什么，不是看说什么众生被杀死，什么众生被杀死不重要，而是你的出发心，你的发心是什么，你发心是要杀人，那你没有成功的话，人被你杀死的话就是重罪，没有杀死的话就是第一级是重品罪。So the key point here is your intention. Your intention is to kill a human, and if you succeed in killing a human, then it's heavy offense. If you does not succeed in killing a human, then it's a one level lighter than heavy, so it's intermediate offense. Okay.Same principle apply to the next, the non-human. You want to kill a non-human, and non-human die is an intermediate offense. If you do not succeed in killing a non-human, then it's going to be one level lighter than this. So it'll be light offense, no matter what being got killed, including human. 那你现在的目的你的动机是要杀非人，非人被你杀死的那是重品罪，那没有被杀死的话是未遂罪，要比这个重品罪来的低一级，所以这是轻罪，不管是畜生也好或者是人啊被你杀，这是轻罪。那同样的，当你要杀畜生的时候，目的是要杀畜生，畜生被你杀死了那就是轻罪，那其他没有其他的，你畜生没有被你杀死就未遂罪的话应该要比轻罪要轻一点，但是我们在戒律里头没有比轻罪还要更轻的，所以其他的众生也还是轻罪，这是为什么，这没有轻罪，就是轻罪。So now if your intention is to kill an animal, and animal is killed by you, then it's a life offense. If you do not succeed in killing an animal, and it's supposed to be lighter than I offense, right? It's you are only attempting here, you does not succeed. You were unsuccessful killing the neighbor. Supposed to be lighter than thy offense, but there's nothing lighter than thy offense. Thy offense is the lowest offense. So they got that offense as well. So that's the principle. 所以要紧的就是看你的出发，你的用心，你的动机在哪里。 你动机要杀人的话，那个动机是很不好的动机，比你动机要杀畜生那个厉害得多，是不是？所以你杀的人那是重罪，那其他的众生被你杀的话就是个从轻罪。那你要杀畜生的话，畜生被你杀死的是轻罪，其他也都是轻罪，因为你那个动机不是那么恶，不是那么毒。 So the important thing is your intention. Your intention of killing a human that's very serious, more serious than intention to kill an animal. That's why when you do not succeed in killing a human, it's still intermediate offense. And when you do not succeed in killing an animal, then it's a die offense. Okay. 所以在即使在五戒里头，这个你的用心还是很重要。不是说有人说菩萨戒才注意到你的起心动念，其实不是这样子。从这里你就看得出来，这个五戒在判罪的时候，就是看你的动机啊。所以你那个。 你的动机，你的心是怎么样想，那个很重要。So there are people say that the bodhisattva precepts, only bodhisattva precepts talking about your intention, your thoughts. Then that's important. But here you can see that even in five precepts, when you determine the severity of the offenses, then the intention is. Most important, right? Most important. It's not only when Bodhisattva precept emphasize intention. 那下面另外一个例子就是说，你做这个火坑，目的是要杀任何的众生，任何众生来死掉都好。So the final case is that you set up this fire pit for any. Living being, you'll be happy any being fall in there. Okay. So in this case, you have intention to kill human, you have intention to kill non-human, you also have intention to kill animal. Okay. 那这个例子里头就是说，你有动机要有杀人的动机，有杀非人的动机，有杀畜生的动机。所以当人死的时候。 那就是个重罪，非人死的时候是中品罪，因为你有杀非人的心，那你有杀畜生的心，所以是个轻罪，这个就很合理，大家容易接受。So have the intention to kill a human die, and so everyone's. You also had intention to kill a non-human, right? So when the non-human die, it's an intermediate offense. When the living animal dies, then it's a die offense. Okay. I didn't have the slide to show the other thing. 那上礼拜我们还谈到一个有意思的，就是说，你如果在这个情形下你都没有杀死的任何众生，那你犯什么样的罪？ Remember, we also talked about that in this last case, if no living being got killed, you still commit offense. And what kind of offenses you committed? Do you remember that? 你如果第一个例子就是说你有杀人的心，对不对？那如果人没有被杀死呢？ 那你就是个杀人未遂了。所以那应该是什么罪？ So now you have the intention to kill human, and no human got killed. So you are unsuccessful in killing human. You commit what kind of offense? 重点罪，对不对？那个比重罪要来得轻，比重要。So that's one case, 那是一个方便罪。那第二个情形就是说，你有杀非人的心，对不对？但是非人没有被你杀死，就是杀非人未遂。那你这个未遂罪的话，应该是哪一种？是重罪，是中罪，还是轻罪？是轻罪，比中罪还要来轻。You also have intention to kill non-human, but you are unsuccessful in killing a non-human, so you commit an offense which is supposed to be lighter than intermediate. It's a light offense, right?Finally, you also have intention to kill an animal. And animal is not killed, so you were unsuccessful in killing animal, and you commit another offense, which is supposed to be lighter than that offense, right? And there's nothing lighter than that, so you have another light offense. 那你杀畜生没有成功的话，应该是比轻罪还来得轻，所以应该是还是轻罪，因为没有比轻罪还要轻的。所以就是有三个方便罪，没有成功的未遂罪，一个就是中品未遂，一个轻品未遂，这个也轻品未遂，所以两个轻罪，一个中罪。So if you were unsuccessful in killing any beingYou commit one intermediate offense in this category, and one light offense here, another light offense here. Okay? Any questions so far? This is a review of what we talked about last week. 有没有什么问题？我们有上有人怎么样？
举手，
那你就很明白。Somebody raise hand?Is that mute already?
No,
I'm not sure. 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 I'm not
sure. I'm not sure.
I'm not sure.
I'm
not sure. I'm not
sure. I'm not sure. I'm not sure. I'm not sure.
I'm not sure. I'm not sure.
I'm not sure. I'm not sure. I'm not sure.喂，阿弥陀佛，法师好。我想请问一下，就是说，如果我有这个 intention， 就是我有杀人的动机，但是呢，没有做任何 action， 就是没有这个有方便，这个也算是中品罪吗？还是说，就是说有 attention， 就是有动机，但是没有做任何行为，这个是没有关系的，还是怎么样来定这个呢？阿弥陀佛，
这个情形的话是没有犯罪，没有。也不叫轻罪，但是我们有一个，就是说你必须要所谓的择心忏，你有那个不好的心念起来的时候，你要赶快打住那个坏的念头，然后你等于说要责备自己，责备自己为什么会有这个坏的念头，因为你如果没有打住的话，你可能就会行动，对不对？采取行动的话，就后果就可能就不堪设想。所以在这个情形下是没有犯戒，但是就是要自己要很小心，要马上把它打住这样子。你可以用英文讲吗？你的问题。
Okay, my question is, if I have intention to kill a human, but finally I have attention to kill human, but I didn't take any action to kill anybody. I just a thought. And my question is, if I just thought, but I didn't put any action, is there still offend any problem?
If you only have intention and the thought, then you didn't commit any offense. Okay, but you have to be very careful. Watch your thoughts. When you have this kind of bad thought, you have to stop it right away. And you also sort of reprimand to scold yourself in your mind. And why I have this kind of evil thought, okay? It's important that you stop it right away. Otherwise, you may take action afterwards, okay? It's,
有另外一个人吗？我一个吗？他是按照他这边有按钮button，我这按钮他那按钮button。Is anyone
raise hand? Another person?
没有了，其实他晚上有人问，8:22。
现在他就举手了，刚刚那个像不是刚刚那个像吗？现在他又举手上。If the intention to kill is in the dream it's okay. You are not commit any offense. But of course, when you wake up, you have to reflect why you had that kind of bad thought in your dream, okay? Usually it's because you have the thought when you are awake, so it carries that thought into your dream. So that's something you have to reflect. 这边一个问题就是说，如果是在梦中有这个不好的念头，要有杀心的话，那怎么是什么样的情形？ 你梦里的当然不算犯戒了，那但是你自己要留意一下，为什么你会有这个杀心在梦里头？有一些梦境是因为你日有所思，夜有所梦，是不是？那你就要自己反省，你是不是白天醒来的时候你有这个不好的念头？那你就要小心，要停止它。 About if killing a person is a duty, such as a soldier or policeman. We talked about this question last week, actually. It's your duty, but you have to think about, do you satisfy those five conditions, five factors? If you satisfy those five factors, then it's a heavy offense. That's why you want to be very careful in choosing your job, your profession, okay? 那他这个问题就是说，如果他的工作是要杀人，比如说是兵、军人啊、警察，那算不算犯戒？我们这个问题上礼拜谈过，你看看你那个那五个条件满足不满足？如果满足的话，就是重罪了。那这个。 所以大家在选择你的工作的时候要很小心了，你要选择一个工作有杀生的工作，比如说杀人啊，你屠宰场工作啊，这个都是造业了。你开的餐馆，荤食的餐馆的话，那也只是造业了，那个就要想办法停下来。So you have to be very careful in choosing your job and your profession. Like killing animal, you work in the slaughterhouse or even a restaurant. If you are not serving vegetarian food, then you involve lots of killing. That's something you want to avoid. And for those in the restaurant business, actually the best thing for you to do is convert to a vegetarian restaurant. 那你如果是开的是荤食的餐馆的话，最好的方式就是把它改成素食餐馆， 那你就将功赎罪，那是最有效的方法。I think that's the most effective way because you start to save living beings, and protect living beings, and then you can pay back your debt very quickly. So, 还有哪些问题？我看一大堆，从哪边开始看起？豆干长毛的，会够。那个毛不是畜生啊，毛是植物啊，对不对？你发霉，那个霉不是动物之类的。
你是指细菌吗？
长毛是一般是长霉啊，对不对？没细菌。你想知道阎罗王给你判几年？我不是阎罗王嘛，所以。Okay, it's not important. I would like to know if you take precepts under mentally your condition and you went through the ceremony, is that still considered taking the precepts? Still have received the precepts? It depends on your mental condition at that time. If you didn't know what's happening, then most likely you won't have the precept with you. Okay?那他这边问到一个问题，就是说他受戒的时候，如果这个人他那个精神有问题的话，那会不会得戒？那这个就看情形了，看他到底那个精神状态怎么样。如果真的是很乱的话，那不可能得戒的。所有的菩萨戒后，如果有起杀人的念头，他没行动。这个受了菩萨戒以后，起杀人的念头没有行动，我相信这个判戒还是跟五戒是一样，这个并没有犯到戒，但是就是说，像我讲的，你必须要有责心忏在那边。我们会谈到菩萨戒，我打算就是说，我们这个五戒的杀戒讲完以后，我就会讲到菩萨戒的杀戒，然后我们来做个比较，这样子就比较清楚。那其实在那个五个条件犯众的条件里头差异不多，菩萨戒那个五戒是杀人才是犯众，这菩萨戒的话是除了人以外，你杀天人的话你也犯众，差别你要只差在这里。 We'll talk about the Bodhisattva precepts later. Actually, my plan is after we finish the killing precepts, the five precepts, we'll move on to talk about the killing precepts in Bodhisattva precepts so that we can compare the differences between the Bodhisattva precept and the five precept in terms of this particular precept. Actually, if you consider those heavy offense for killing, those five factors, the difference is not that much. The difference is that for the human, the five precepts, only killing human is a heavy offense. But for five precepts,besides killing human, if you are able to kill a deva, a god, then it's also a heavy offense. That's the difference. I think that's a major difference. So the difference is not that big, actually. We'll talk about that more detail later. What about transfer marriage to animals or insects, to embers and death, and reborn to ordinary place? So consider a bad intention to kill animal. Why is this an intention to kill your animal? You help them, right? You dedicate marriage to them and to end birth and death. you are not killing them. You wish them to have a good rebirth. You create merit, actually. 他这边问的问题是说，他如果是回向功德给畜生啊，给昆虫，希望他们能够离苦得乐，了生脱死，升到极乐世界去。那这个算不算是一个坏的动机要杀动物？这个你的动机不是要杀动物啊，对不对？你是要回向功德给他们，让他们能够了生脱死。你除非你是动手去杀他unless you take action to kill them, then that's a different story.、I didn't know.、I'm not sure. I don't know your question because the when mental illness has a different label. I'm not sure. Not sure. Okay. I can't answer your question at this time. Xiaomu 不是畜生啊，酵母菌啊。细菌不是畜生。Bacteria is not considered as the animals or insects. So, killing bacteria is no problem. Like you take the antibiotics, it's no problem. 像你吃抗生素，抗生素是杀菌的，那个不算杀生。那杀病毒更不用说了，病毒是比细菌还要更低一层。Virus is even lower than bacteria. So if you killing virus, it's okay. You are not killing any living being. 超市肉类部门的工作人员是否也是犯杀罪？这个我们以后再谈好不好？我们会谈到那个吃荤的问题，堕胎也是一样，我们会谈到堕胎的问题。今天也许有时间会谈到堕胎，其实下一个就是要谈堕胎。是不是？是 Mandy。有一个人，他的 raise hand， 你有没有看到 ？Tim 说 ，Mandy iPad is a blue hand raised icon appear for some time now。
嗯，问题我，因为他是用 iPad 电源板用把灯，而且他们两个烧的歌嘛，用把灯给他用。
你没有看，你没有看他名字吗？
有看到。
那。没有，他不是有一个那个举手的。
对。
那你按他那个举手的那个 button。
Okay,
没有。
没有了，不进了。你先找他一下。
你把 unmute 他就不见了。Mandy 你的 ，you can talk now， 你可以讲话了 ，Mandy。If you still want to talk, Okay, 怎么样忏? We'll talk about repentance, how you repent later, not today. Okay, I think it's time to move on and save the questions you have. And the next subtopic is called, this is almost like an abortion, but it's not necessarily an abortion, it's called terminating a pregnancy. 这边是讲到堕胎，这个堕胎不是说光你自己要去堕，别人想办法把你的那个胎打掉， 都属于这个问题。我们来念念这个经文。So we'll read the sutra text, Chinese first, then the English, okay? 和长念中文。又复堕胎者，与有胎女人涂下药，即观一切畜药，若真血脉，乃至出眼泪药，作是念，以是因缘，令女人死。In the case of terminating a pregnancy, suppose that an upasaka administers to a pregnant woman drugs that cause either vomiting or diarrhea, they fill all parts of the body, or let shed tears, or uses acupuncture with the thought, through this way, let this woman die. Okay. 那这个就是讲到堕胎，就是这个女人怀胎了，那用不同的方法要让，其实你目的是要让这个女人，这个妇人死掉，你的手段是要把她的胎打掉，那借着打她胎的话要让女人死。 So this is a case you want to kill the mother by terminating pregnancy, okay? So your purpose, your intention is not to kill the fetus, your intention is to kill the mother, okay? And you use different ways, okay? Let's continue, 继续。死者犯不可悔罪，若不及死，后因是死。一般不可悔罪，若不及死，后不应死，是重罪可悔。If the woman dies, the upasaka commits an offense that cannot be repented. If the woman does not die immediately, but dies later due to the cause, the upasaka also commits an offense that cannot be repented. If the woman does not die either immediately or later,The upasaka commits an intermediate offense that may be rendered. 这个和我们上礼拜讲的是一模一样，对。你要杀这个女人，如果这个女人死的话，那就不可悔了。那即使不是当场死，后来死掉的话，也是不可悔，也是重罪。不管她死的快慢，都是因为你把他那个胎打掉的话，他死掉的话，那就是重罪。如果他没有死，这个女人没有死的话，就是重病罪。So the severity of the offenses are the same as what we talked about last week, or like the fire pit situation. If this woman you intended to kill died,No matter when she died right away or died later, it's a heavy offense. If she doesn't die, then it's an intermediate offense. Okay? Let's continue. 继续。若为杀母故堕胎，若母死者犯不可悔，若胎死者是罪可悔，若俱死者是罪不可悔。若俱不死者，是重罪可悔。If the intention of terminating a pregnancy is to kill the mother, and the mother dies, it's an offense that cannot be repented. If the fetus dies, then it's an offense that may be repented. If both the mother and fetus die, it's an offense that cannot be repented.If neither dies, it's an intermediate offense that may be repented. 那这个你把胎打掉，目的是要杀这个母亲。那母亲死的话，当然是个重罪，不可悔，对不对？那如果母亲没有死，而是那个胎儿死的话，这个不是重罪， 因为你的动机，你的出发点不是杀胎儿，你要杀母亲，所以这是杀这个母亲未遂，所以这个中品罪。So if your intention is to kill the mother, and the mother dies, of course, it's a heavy offense. Now, if the mother doesn't die, and the fetus dies instead, then you are unsuccessful in killing the mother. So it's not a heavy offense. It's an intermediate offense. It's an intermediate offense. 那如果都死母亲也死胎儿也死的话这个不可悔为什么因为母亲死了对不对所以就是不可悔是重罪不可悔那如果是都不死的话就是母亲也没有死啊那就未遂是个重病罪 So if both mother and fetus die then you succeed in killing the mother then it's a heavy offense. You cannot repent. If neither one dies, then you were unsuccessful killing a mother, then it's an intermediate offense. Okay. Continue. 继续。若为杀胎故，作大胎法。若胎死者，患不可悔；若胎不死者，是重罪可悔；若母死者，是重罪可悔；俱死者，是犯不可悔，是名堕胎法。If the intention of terminating a pregnancy is to kill the fetus, and the fetus dies, it's an offense that cannot be repented.If the fetus survives, it's an intermediate offense that may be repented. If the mother dies, it's also an intermediate offense that may be repented. If both die, it's an offense that cannot be repented. 那这个就反过来了，刚刚是你目的是要杀母亲，那现在你目的是要杀这个胎儿，那胎儿死的话，这个当然是重罪不可悔，胎儿不死的话就是个重品罪了。即使母亲死都是重罪，重品罪，对不对？那如果都死的话，就表示胎儿也死掉了，那就当然就是重罪不可悔。So this is just the opposite. Previous night, your intention is to kill the mother. Now your intention is to kill the fetus. So if the fetus dies, then it's a heavy offense, right? If the fetus survives, then it's an intermediate offense. And if the mother dies, in other words, the fetus survives, then it's also an intermediate offense. Both die, that means the fetus also dies, so it's a heavy offense, okay?我们回过头来看看这个杀重罪的五个缘。So let's come back to this table. The five factors as present for heavy offense. The first factor is a human, right? 第一个条件就是说杀的对象是个人。那第二个条件我们说是人相。The second factor we say this is a human, okay? 但是刚刚的情形是你要杀母亲，但是胎儿死的话，那个胎儿也是人啊，对不对？那你如果说也是人想的话，那个也是个人，你也满足这个条件。So, 那我们想还继续下去啊 ，okay? Let's continue. We want to consider about the case we will just talk about that you want to kill the mother but the fetus dies. The fetus is also human and also you perceive that as a human. And you also have intention to kill, right? But your intention is to kill the mother. 你有杀心，这个是杀杀母亲的心。那有的动作，命断的，the victim die. Okay. 那我们现在回过头来看看。也许我们说你目的是要杀胎儿，因为有的人会问说，那胎儿什么算人？胎儿算是人的。如果是你目的是要杀胎儿，就像我们一般聊堕胎是要堕胎儿嘛，杀。所以胎儿是个人，那你当然也当着人像，你有杀心，对，那你有方。有动作，那胎儿命也死了，那当然就是个重罪。但是你如果是你要杀胎儿，但是母亲死了，母亲也是个人嘛，对不对？这母亲也是个人，那他这个也应该是也满足了，因为他是一个人想嘛。但是差别是你没有杀母亲的心，对不对？没有杀那个母亲的心呢，那你虽然有动作，然后这个命断不是胎儿命断，是母亲命断，所以这个条件也不满足。所以这边有至少有两个条件不满足，你没有杀母亲的心，也没有母亲，你没有杀母亲的心，那胎儿也没有死掉。虽然母亲死掉，但是这个命断，这虽然命断，但是这里指的那个胎儿的命断，胎儿的命断。So we take a situation that you want to abort the fetus, and yet the mother died. Okay, the mother is a human, right? So satisfy this condition, this factor.And you also perceive that as a human. However, you don't have the intention to kill the mother. Your intention is to kill the fetus. And you have actions. Then the victim dies. The victim here is the fetus. And, but the fetus doesn't die, the mother died. So it doesn't satisfy this.Back to Eden. So 这个要紧就是说你这边起杀心就是你要是要不是说光杀人，你是要杀哪一个人。你这种目的不是要杀，好比说你不是要杀母亲，那就不满足这个条件，而不是说只是因为 要杀人。当然你如果是想杀母亲也要杀胎儿也好的，那另外一回事情。那这个命断就是说，你必须是你要杀的对象命断，那才满足这个条件。所以你即使是你要堕胎，但是母亲死掉的，胎儿没有死，那这个胎儿命没有断，即使母亲丧失命呢，也没有满足条件。所以这应该指的那个人就是这个胎儿的命。So,When you want to abort the fetus, your purpose is to kill the fetus. However, the fetus doesn't die, and the mother dies. Even though the mother is a human, satisfy this factor, you can say you also perceive as a human. However, you don't have the intention to kill the mother. So this intention here has to be very specific.It's not just the intention to kill any human. And the victim dies. This cannot be just a general victim. This must be the person you intend to kill. In this case, this must be a fetus. The fetus must die. Okay. The fetus doesn't die, then doesn't satisfy this factor. And the mother dies. And the mother died doesn't.Satisfy this factor because this factor needs to be more specific. It's not any any human dying. It's not any victim. And the victim is too general a term. You can say that person, the one you intend to kill, dies. Okay. Kalala is a human embryo. When the rudiments of body and life have just developed in the womb, if an action is taken with the intent to kill such an embryo, and the embryo dies, the offender commits an offense that cannot be repented. If the embryo survives, the vasaka commits an intermediate offense that may be repented, as discussed above. 这里就讲到那个胎儿的问题，在这个胎儿出的二根，生根命根，这个叫迦罗罗。迦罗罗这个定义是说，父母亲的父精母血，就是等于母亲的卵受精以后，受精卵出和合，所以一旦精子进入卵，那时候开始就算这个叫做迦罗罗，这个是从受生之初至七日间第一个礼拜，从那个卵子受精开始到一个礼拜，这个叫做迦罗罗。OK， 那这时候已经算是一个人了，就是你杀的话就已经是个重罪。So the Kalala is an embryo.This is definition is during the first 7 days of the pregnancy. As soon as the sperm enter the egg, then start to count. Okay, from that point on for 7 days, that the embryo is called Kalala. If you kill the Kalala, then it's a heavy offense. So it's considered as a human already. Okay, so that's something that people had to be very careful.那这个就是我们要非常小心的，因为现在法律里头有一些是说胎儿多大以后你才不能够堕，对不对？但是你从佛教的观点来看的话，那个精子一进入到卵子，那已经不能够堕了。I think the law, country laws, some places say that it'sAfter the fetus is a certain age, then you are not supposed to abort it. Otherwise, you break the law. But in Buddhism, it's not the case. As soon as the sperm enter the egg, then if you abort this egg, then it's a heavy one already. 那个避孕药大家也要很少见，你如果是结婚的人的话，因为有些避孕药说是你行房以后第二天早上吃那个避孕药，把那个受精卵排掉。那你想想啊，那个受精卵是不是已经是个迦罗罗了？迦罗了。那there are pills people take.After the next morning, for contraceptive. And according to this definition, it's too late already. Right? That's, the next morning, the egg is also become this kalala already. So if you take the pill the next morning, you are killing a kalala. That's why that.People have to be very careful. Okay. 所以这个大家要很小心，这个避孕你要非常留意，不是说所有的避孕药都可以吃的。 如果是从佛教观点来看的话， so that's something that people need to be very careful about. Okay, so I think we'll probably stop here for more questions, because the next topic is a different topic. 那我想我们在这边就先停下来，因为接下来是不同的题材。那这个避孕的那个堕胎的问题就是到这边为止。如果有问题的话，你可以举手或者是打到 chat box 里头。If you have questions, you can raise your hand or type into the chat box.从哪里开始？
八品上乘七分，一个七的八品上乘七分，金曼丽
，家里亲人一定要租房子给荤菜饭店，属于什么罪？你房子租给这个餐馆，你多多少少是牵涉到，不是直接的，对不对？但是当然也不是个清净业了。那能够避免最好是避免，没有办法避免的话，你就多回向啊，你就多做功德，多放生、护身，鼓励人家吃素。你说，多印素食食谱了，推广素食来补救了。So this is a case that they have house, they have rent to restaurant that is not vegetarian restaurant. And of course, they also involve in killing in some extent indirectly. So we still try to avoid that as much as possible. Now you have dedicated Mary or try to promote vegetarians.And circulate the vegetarian cookbook. Peter, 你要不要 unmute?
已经 answer 了，已经
answer 了 question. 已经 answer 了 question.
因为你的已经 answer 了，
所以我不用再。
因为那个阿叔汉子知道 answer 了，
不用再问。You know, this can be a very emotional topic. So many people did not know, and if you did not know before, then you just have to repent. Okay, don't do that again in the future. 那这个堕胎是一个很敏感的问题，我晓得很多人不懂，所以从前也许就已经堕了胎了。那过去就过去了，也没有办法了，就是多做功德，回向放生，以后不要再，千万不要再重犯，是这样子。Okay. Any other questions?
Yeah. 是7:55分最早一个。
7:55。什么问题？
我们为什么就是不能养猫？妈妈帮我们把这个
养。有人举手。你要跟他讲什么人啊？
是我。
Somebody raise hand, you can speak now. 谁举手的现在可以发言？You can speak now. The one who raise hand.谁刚刚举手了？你麦克风已经开了。Two people raise hand.
法师，金老师。This is Ethan here.
Your voice is very soft. Hold on.
法师，金庸师 ，This is Ethan from Malaysia.
Yes.
法师 ，I just now asked the question. Let's say if I took the precepts, and I was under a very, I was mentally ill, and then whether I would have received the precept substance or not, I was in the state where like I know how to behave in front of society, but my mind was very confused. So when I took the precepts, I was quite confused and I was in a radical state of mind. So I don't know whether I have received the precept substance or not.
I don't know either. Sorry.
So but, I don't know who to consult, because if I didn't receive the precepts, that means I didn't commit and that I didn't violate any precepts. But if I did receive the precepts, that means I have violated at least one of the precepts. So I'm not too sure who to go to resolve this.
Is that a heavy offense?
It's the offense against stealing.
Stealing?
Yeah. And I committed like a down. Sorry?
Probably not a heavy offense. We'll talk about the stealing later. If it's not a heavy offense, it's easy to repent. Okay? It's easy to repent. You don't have to worry about it because you are not in a good condition when you receive the precept.
Yes, and then after that, I have the doctor saying that I have the schizoaffective disorder. He diagnosed me with a disease called the schizoaffective disorder, he said.
Mm-hmm.
So that means I do have a mentally ill condition.
I'm sure Buddhas, Bodhisattvas know your condition very well. So they probably won't give you the precept.
Okay.
They knew that.
Amitabha.
They knew okay. That you are not in the state of receiving the precept. Don't worry about it, okay?
Okay, Amitabha, Jin Yong Shi.
Amitabha. So, Zheng Liwen, is that? Zheng Liwen, do you want to speak? Zheng Liwen, 你要谁呀？你要讲
刘
红艳是吧？
啊，
他是手还是曲折？
啊，没有的。
啊，没有的。
啊，
刘红艳，你可以是叫红艳吧？是不是？
啊，
说你的麦克风开了吗？
我没有问题。
你没有问题，那你说举手。
点错了。
点错了，你可以又可以把取消掉。
曾
立文 ，You want to speak？
啊，先生啊，法师啊，阿弥陀佛，各位向真身，阿弥陀佛，我有。
等一下，你的很多杂音啊。
很多杂音的。
呀，非常多杂音。你那个麦克风有什么问题吗？
我现在laptop 的麦克风，没关系啊，我英语来问问题啊，可以吗？
你最好是用打到 chat box 吧，因为你讲话杂音太大，怕听不清楚，好不好听？
Okay.
You probably want to get a better microphone because we 不能够听清楚很多杂讯。Other questions?
我忘了一个 question。
啊？
啊，九点零四到
最后一个。9:04。
啊，最后一个。
我的爸爸妈妈堕胎，我如何做有利于我的爸妈？ 你可以替那个坛人立牌位，可以替那立牌位，那多做功德回向咯。放生啊，护生这些，他没有名字也可以立牌位啦。我们那个在万华城这边的往生堂有很多都是这种胎儿，没有名字的胎儿，有的是第一胎、第二胎，不止一胎的，有父母亲的名字就可以了。So if your parents aboard any baby, then you can actually set up plate for this fetus. And even though they don't have name, you can use your parents' name and say that the fetus aborted by them. We got many plate here at CTB. The consequence of, let's see, so consequence of taking birth control pill that are intended to stop sperm and egg from coming together. If you just stop the sperm into egg, then from Buddhist point of view, it's from precept point of view, you are not breaking precept, right? Because it's not Kalala yet. 那这边他有一个问题，就是说，如果这个避孕药是让这个精子阻止精子进入卵子的话，那这个是什么？有没有犯什么？有没有什么果报？这个在从戒的观点来看的话，没有犯戒，因为这时候他们还不知道那迦罗拉的那个的阶段。So, 真理文 I read the Dharma Flower Sutra Medicine, the friend himself to offer the Buddha. Same goes to the sages. If we as ordinary person do such action, do we commit any offense? This is not easy, okay? You burn yourself. Don't try that. You can't take it. You don't have the samadhi. And you can try to, like, in some places, the monastery, you can burn the incense, like, put the incense stick on your body. You try that first, see if you can endure that. And okay, and don't try to burn your whole body. It's not fun. Okay. The 排位什么时间呢？现在我们圣城，你可以电邮到我们的功德部去。功德部那个一位金刚法师，他的电邮，你就可以跟他联络，然后看怎么样的。Okay. So for the tech, you can even though CDB is closed, you can still set up tech.Usually what you do is you email to our donation department and starting from there, they'll tell you the cost and also you need to provide the name, things like this. Okay. The email address, I think maybe I can type it now or what? I'm not sure whether I remember it.Maybe I'll show that next week. How about that? 那个功德部的那个 金刚宝池的电邮，我想我下礼拜再给大家好了，现在不见得找得到。万魔城是在森林里吗？怎么有孔雀？我们这里是野生动物园啊。我们不但有孔雀，有松鼠，各种鸟，还有什么鹿，很多啊，狐狸都有啊。还有人呢、啊，还有不同的众生。How about freezing the egg for future use and then discard the rest of the egg after a while? Eggs itself is no problem because it's not considered as a living being yet. So the freezing the egg is no problem, and you discard the egg, that's no problem yet.鸡蛋可以吃吗？这个问题我们留着以后再谈了，我们会谈到吃荤的问题，另外会谈到蛋的问题。很快的回答，上人曾经回答过这个问题，他说当你当鸡的时候，你就晓得蛋可不可以吃。OK，你去当鸡的时候，你就晓得能不能吃蛋。There's a question here, just whether we can eat eggs. And I think we'll discuss this later in more detail, but just quick answer. The people ask this question to the Venerable Master, and the Master replied that you'll know.When you become, you are reborn as a chicken, you know whether it's okay to eat eggs or not. 病的时候，我们说病的时候就是看，要看情形的。你如果说一个开源的情形，就是说你这个吃蛋可以治病的话。那可以吃，但是你不是治病，只是说为了要身体能够复原的快啦，或者怎么样的，那就另外一回事了。OK，Corinne 已经有 email address， so if you 在 chat box 里头 ，Corinne 已经把那个金刚法师的 email address 打出来了。So there's an email address for donation department, the Thomas Jingang, jingang88@gmail.com. Okay, it's very easy. 国内收不到，中国封锁。我听说你们都懂得怎么爬墙，不是吗？那就找办法，想办法找人家帮你透过第三者的。我晚课按照猫城的课，应该是可以给。我不懂这个问题，范进的问题是什么？晚课按照猫城的课本。这是什么问题？你按照万华城的课本做晚课是吧？可以啊，没有问题啊。但是那个放门山的地方不要去做它。晚课那个放门山不要去做。When you do the evening ceremony, you follow our recitation handbook, it's okay, except you don't.Try to feed the ghost. Okay, don't try to feed the ghost. 但是其实上人最近有一个回答，他讲说，出家人能够做，在家人都可以做，只要你不收钱的话。没有事实，只是读。你这那一部分就把它跳过去好了 ，OK， 你不要去读它。嗯，所以你就不要去读它了。这边中间 ，OK。Any other questions？ 有没有其他问题？没有的话，我们
有人举手，
有人举手。
可瑞阿米拉，
可瑞啊，
啊，阿米拉，
可瑞，你要
啊，可以讲话，
你可以讲话了。
法师，
怎么样？
法师，我有问题想请问你，就是我前两天帮一个朋友买那个鹦鹉啦，然后。因为他住的离我比较就是有就是还要开车过去，所以就是我要帮他养个两三天，然后再送去给他。结果呢，那个鹦鹉是 baby 嘛，然后就养了隔天就死。那这样我算不算杀生？
你有要杀他的念头吗？
我没有啊。
对呀、啊。那自己、
oh, okay.
他自己死掉的、啊，
对他自己死掉的，
他自己死掉的，跟你、
oh,
没有关系啊，除非是你，
oh,
除非是你都不管他，存心让他死，对不对？
有喂他，可是就不知道就这样走掉了。
嗯
嗯 ，OK， 好，那我知道，好，
okay.
阿弥陀佛。
Okay.If no other questions, we'll dedicate merit. How about it? 如果没有问题的话，那我们就回向功德了，好吧？下礼拜再继续看。有没有忘啊？还有问题啊？
我是做
工
地，重点是
做工。在圈里头。酒驾撞死人算什么？算撞死人了。这个，你酒驾撞死人，你从戒律上你没有那个杀人的心，对不对？但是呢，你有业报罪啊，你还要造的果报。所以虽然你没有犯戒，但是你喝酒就犯戒了，那个是轻罪，就是。那个业报罪是逃不了的，我们也会谈一谈这个业报罪跟犯戒罪的，我们要分清楚。So the one question here is that the drunk driving and kill a person, then about a situation like this, you don't have intention to kill.So from precept point of view, you don't commit the killing offense. However, there's still karma. You have to pay back that. So there are two different types of offenses. One is due to karma, and the other one is due to breaking precept. Okay. In this case, you don't break the precept against killing. However,You break precept of taken in Tuscans, right? That actually is a heavy offense. But you kill a person by accident, even though you are not breaking precepts, you create some bad karma, killing karma, you have to pay back in the future.迷离生从，充实太多太多怎么办？那你要避免它了，最好是这样子。 我们的厨房也常常从前有这个问题，我不晓得他们现在怎么处理。诺伊说你把米放在冰箱就不会长虫了，你家里冰箱要大一点。In summertime, when we are driving, we wear many insects in the windshield and die. I know that's not avoidable, so that's why we have to be very careful. You don't have intention, however, you create killing karma. 你开车的时候，这个挡风玻璃很多都是。这是那些昆虫啊，撞伤还撞死。你没有杀心，所以大概没有犯戒，但是你还是有杀业，杀业有果报的。Okay, okay. I think save questions next time. We'll dedicate merit. Okay, 你说还有问题的话，那就是下礼拜谈。嗯，回向功德。Merit the spreads along all the distance.Repay the kindness from above and rescue those in heaven below. May all who see or hear on us resolve our awakening. And when the spotty is ascending, born together in the land of this big house. Now in respect to the Venerable Master,阿弥陀佛。